exposure for fact-checking efforts around the world. Specifically, the goal of our project is to be able to take sentences from news shows like CNN or Fox, YouTube videos, live streams, and microphone audio, and return all related fact checks in one database, the Share the Facts database, which has around 17,000 previously checked facts and is compiled by fact-checking organizations around the world. And as of last time, we decided to approach this problem using two machine learning models, the first of which being a long short-term memory neural network, and the second of which being a more traditional natural language processing approach using support vector machines. So using the first approach, the way we represented each sentence was with a 300 by 50 matrix. 300 because each of the pre-trained Google word embeddings we used to represent each sentence was a length 300 vector, and 50 because we would either zero pad or shorten each sentence to around 50 words. And using the second approach, the way we represented each sentence was by first analyzing them with hard-of-speech tagging and then comparing each word across the two sentences using a word pair similarity score. And then we fed those features that we constructed into a support vector machine for classification. And as of last time, the way we had chosen to define our problem was as a binary classification problem. So given two sentences, A and B, we called them a paraphrase if A implied B and B implied A.
So now we want to take a closer look at the sort of sentences that our algorithms perform well on and those on which they don't perform as well. So we're going to use the sentence, last year we lost $500 billion in trade with China, as our spoken sentence. And this is something Donald Trump said in a press conference this year. And we've color-coded the sentence, sort of splitting it into parts based on meaning. And then we're going to compare it against possible sentences that could be in our database. So first, in 2017, we lost $500 billion in trade with China. And as you can see, these sentences are very similar. And our algorithm performs very well in this sort of sentence. It's good at matching 500 billion and knowing that that's the same as half a trillion, or last year and in 2017. And we find that our algorithms still perform well as these sentences get more complicated. So now, trade deficit with China was $500 billion in 2017. Now, with China has moved from the end of the sentence to closer to the beginning, and even more complicated, trade deficit matches with loss in trade, which is not even consecutive words. But we still find that our algorithms perform well in this sort of example. However, obviously our algorithms aren't perfect. And particularly, they're bad with sentences which share many words but differ in words critical to overall meaning. So for example, we've lost 500 factories since 2017 due to trade with China. One sentence is talking about losing money due to trade, and the other is about losing factories. So these sentences aren't saying the same thing, but again, we see that they have so many words and with similar meanings. So while we are looking through the sentences that our algorithms perform well on and poorly, we realize that we are looking at the problem too narrowly. If you recall, we are looking for paraphrases. However, we realized that we also need to be looking for entailment, which is when one sentence, in our case the sentence in the database, implies the meaning of the spoken sentence. So for example, the ball is round and shiny implies the ball is round. But those aren't paraphrases because one has more information than the other. And paraphrase is really a subset of entailment, and you can think of it as entailment in both directions. And in addition, we want to be looking for contradictions, when one sentence implies that the other one is false. So the ball is blue is a contradiction with the ball is green. So once we realized that we had to broaden our problem, we first looked to see if our current methods would extend well to entailment and contradiction. And we found that the answer was no. So as an example, trade deficit with China was $1 trillion in 2016 and half that in 2017. So first, this sentence is much more difficult than the sentences we were originally dealing with. It requires knowing that 1 trillion in 2016 and half that in 2017 is equivalent to 500 billion last year, which is much more complex than what we were doing before. And specifically, our models have a lot of trouble identifying that these white boxes correspond to that 500 billion. So we sort of had to go back to the drawing board. And first, we needed to find a new data set, because the data set we were using before was paraphrase and not paraphrase. Luckily, we found the multi-genre NLI dataset, where NLI stands for Natural Language Inference, which is the common name for this problem. This has 433,000 sentence pairs across 9 genres, including fiction, telephone speech, and a government report after 9/11. And each sentence pair is coded as either entailment, contradiction, and neutral, neutral being neither contradiction nor entailment. And since paraphrase is a subset of entailment, as we mentioned earlier, all paraphrases are marked as entailment. And just to read an example that it sort of shows how difficult this data set is, the telephone speech contradiction. Yes, now you know if everybody, like in August, when everybody's on vacation or something, we can dress a little more casual, or is a contradiction with August is a blackout month for vacations in the company. So this leads us to sort of a summary of what we've been working on since our last presentation. We've been shifting our focus from pure paraphrase matching to contradiction and entailment, and we've been using the MNLI dataset to train models and test.
So right now, the state-of-the-art model for entailment was developed at OpenAI and published just a month ago in June. And one of the biggest problems in NLP is that there's not a lot of labeled data, or at least not enough for a lot of models. So they decided to take a semi-supervised approach. There's a lot more unlabeled data, because that's just text. You can find that basically anywhere. So their idea was they would take a model that would do text prediction based on an input text of a fixed length. And they trained it to do that, and then they looked at the penultimate layer of that neural network as a form of a sentence embedding. They said that if we train this on a lot of text, then we think that this neural network, this layer, will represent a lot of what's going on in the sentence. So that would then be the feature in a normal model that's basically taking the place of the word to vec or whatever other embeddings most models use. You can think of that as advanced sentence embeddings. So they trained this model on 7,000 books over 1 billion words. They trained it for 30 days on 8 GPUs. And once they got this pre-trained model, they were able to apply these embeddings to other problems very easily because they already had done the difficult training. Then they just needed to train it on the smaller data sets like multi-NLI. So they found that these advanced sentence embeddings outperformed the state-of-the-art scores in 12 of 15 well-known NLP challenges, including the one relevant to us, the multi-NLI data set. So they called this pre-trained model, this unsupervised pre-trained model, the Transformer. So let's look a little more at that. It was created initially by engineers at Google 8 months ago, but not applied to NLP until OpenAI. And it improves upon all of the current best methods in NLP, RNN, CNN, LSTM. And it's a lot more dynamic than word embeddings. It's a lot better also at using the surrounding words to determine what each word means in context, which is something that a lot of the current algorithms struggle with. So to show that, we can see an example on the left here. The top sentence is, the animal didn't cross the street because it was too tired. It's very clear to a human that it, in that case, refers to the animal. But if we look at the second sentence, the animal didn't cross the street because it was too wide. It's also very clear that now it refers to the street, but it's very difficult to tell a computer how to figure out what it is referring to in that case. But this transformer, this pre-trained transformer model, is actually really, really good at figuring stuff like that out. So they published this model, pre-trained transformer sentence embedding model, so that anyone can use it and achieve their state-of-the-art results without a lot of training, because they just need to train on the second data set. So we did that. We trained it on multi-NLI, and we achieved 85% accuracy on their data set, which is very close to state-of-the-art.
So kind of concurrent to all of this, we created a demo to allow us to interact with the progress that we've made so far. So here's a little video of that. And what you're looking at is we put in the State of the Union at the very top, and right now what's happening is that the code is going through all that text and returning any relevant fact checks that it's finding from the Share the Facts database. So right now we put in the State of the Union, but you can put in any text you want, and we're also working on making it so that you can put in videos and other audio streams. Oh, and in addition, this demo runs off of our pipeline, so you can plug in any model that you would like to into this. Okay. So as you can see here, the very last sentence of this big text block here is, so let us begin tonight by recognizing that the state of our union is strong because our people is strong, and together we're building a safe, strong, and proud America. Since the election, we've created 2.4 million new jobs, including 200,000 in manufacturing alone. And we found that fact check in our database by the Washington Post, which actually exactly quotes that and says, not the whole story. Yep. Okay. These are our sponsors and other organizations working with us. And you guys have any questions?